happy last day of school. It gives us incredible pleasure to be able to return to these traditional events. These traditional events in our school does not happen without an unbelievable effort from people who really care about you and your experience. So please, a round of applause for the folks who have organized this. This is Hogan, this is Pickford, this is Cottingham, this is Casale. This stuff doesn't happen without their above and beyond effort, as well as Mrs. Fridley. They were here till 5 o'clock yesterday afternoon, getting everything ready for you to have a great show today. So I was able to get a listen to and a quick sneak preview of a lot of the acts. We have some fantastically talented acts that are going to happen today, so we're going to have a great day. And we have a very special MC host today for your entertainment. Mr. Mascarelli, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, for the very first time, your very own MC for tonight's show, Mr. Tyrone Noted.
Finally here. One more round of applause for everyone being here and made it to the last day of school. One quick announcement from your period one teachers. Please make sure you charge your Chromebooks. I was told to say that. Now for your judges for today's talent show. He's a music teacher. He's very handsome. I love him, and I know you do too. Mr. Stilettano! Next to Mr. Stilettano, she's a very lovely lady. She speaks Spanish. Mrs. Scarlett! And finally, our third judge. One of my favorite people in this whole school. Oh, that's right. Oh. He's my best friend. Mr. Hanson! Oh, man. Are you guys excited? Because I'm excited. Are you guys ready? Introducing the first act, another Spanish teacher, Mrs. Urbina.
Wow, this is awesome. This is awesome. I'm so excited, guys. The energy here is crazy, but I am pleased to be able to present the first person here. His name is Nathan Furman.
Thank you.
listen, I know you're so excited, you just crushed these drums. What do you think? How do you think you did? Because I want to know how long you've been playing drums for.
I think I did okay.
You did okay? How long have you been playing drums for?
2 years.
2 years? 2 years you've been playing? Hey, give it up for another round of applause for Nathan. We will go to our judges. Levi, Mr. Hansen, what did you think?
Well, as a professional connoisseur of drum playing, in that I've played Rock Band one time, I gotta say, incredible stick control, incredible tempo control, so fun to watch. My one critique, I prefer a stick flip as to a spike, but I respect that artistic creativity. Great job.
The judges do have the sticks. Ms. Siskarvitz.
So I was super impressed. That was an original drum solo. That was awesome. You did so many different rhythms and different styles and like your face, you were totally into it. It was very impressive. And also I have to say, on a fashion note, you matched your shirt with your drum set, so that's also an extra pop. Nicely done for visual.
Even a style of fashion, he can do it all. Mr. Stiltano!
What an exciting start to today's talent show. That was awesome. Really loved it. Loved the variety, like Ms. Scarlett said, the different work they got. You got a lot of good tom work in there, which I really enjoyed. I love the variety, including the 3-4 passage. Really, really great. Things for you to continue to work on is just working on a constant, steady beat within each section. And I really loved in the middle section, the flexibility I saw on your pinkies and ring fingers as you were playing allowed you to do a lot of good stick work. Just try to keep that fluidity in your hands throughout the whole time. Great work.
One more time for Nathan Furman. For 2 years, that's unbelievable.
We'll just have to clear the stage. Introducing our next performance. He is also a science teacher. He's an eighth grade teacher. Mr. Richard.
All right, our next performance, straight from the green team, the dynamic duo performing Anything You Can Do from Andy Get Your Gun. Please let's hear it for Kate and Molly.
Anything you can do, I can do better, so my name should be first.
Yeah, that's not true at all, because... Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
Cheese.
And only on that?
Yes.
So can a rat.
Anything you can sing, I can sing higher.
I can sing anything higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 I can do that too, see?
Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents. 30 cents.
20 cents.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say anything softer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
knickers faster than a flicker.
I can sew some quicker and make them even thicker.
I can open any safe
without being caught.
Sure.
That's what I thought, you crook.
Any load you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any no longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say faster.
I can say anything faster than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can knit a sweater.
I can wear it better.
I can do most anything.
Can you pick up? Neither can I.
Anything you can sing, I can sing sweeter.
I can sing anything sweeter than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't, can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Wow, Molly and Kate, that was amazing. I don't think I can do anything better than you two. I don't think so, no. Ladies, how long have you been singing? That's the real question everyone wants to know.
A long time.
Well, what's a long time, Kate?
An amount of time that I definitely know, for sure.
Multiple years.
Yes.
Multiple years.
An amount of years, yes.
An amount of years, okay. Well, thank you.
Math,
no. No, math's not your subject. That's okay.
Not right now.
We have a science guy for that. That's why.
Yeah.
Mr. Hansen, what did you think of that?
That was awesome. Again, sticking with my qualifications because I'm insecure about my qualifications to be up here. I was once in the stage play, Annie Get Your Guns, as Buffalo Bill. And I gotta say, what you just did right there was better than the entire production that I was a part of. I love the way that you guys interact with each other while still letting the audience focus on the music. That was very funny. Great job.
Mrs. Scarlett.
So being the musical theater person that I actually am, I was super impressed because it is a classic. And you guys did your choreography, and you did your acting, and you did your singing. You had the whole package together, and you coordinated yourselves, and it was terrific. You guys did a great job.
Mr. Stiltano.
Also, I would like to say as well, really, really great. The confidence you had on the stage was really outstanding. It allowed all of us to truly enjoy the performance. A great, great piece of music from a great show. Really funny, really well done. Your facial expressions, your interactions, the staging was really, really outstanding. That was awesome. Very good. You should be very proud of yourselves.
One more time for Molly and Kay. Sorry about that. Just had to confirm one thing. Sorry about that. Next, introducing our next act. She is from the Orange Team. She does like math, so she can help Kate and Molly. Miss Shaughnessy!
Diego will be performing Photograph by Ed Sheeran.
Wait for me to come home.
Wait for me to come home. Wait for me to come home. Or you can fit me inside the necklace you got when you were 16. Next to your heartbeat where I should be. Keep it deep within your soul. And if you hurt me, well, that's okay, baby. Only words bleed. Inside these pages, you just hold me. You won't ever be alone. When I'm away, I will remember how you kissed me under the lamppost back on 6th Street, hearing you whisper through the phone. Wait for me to come home.
I feel like there's a lot of love now in this room that you've just poured in here, Sue Debbie. A lot of love. How long have you been playing guitar?
4 years.
4 years. Do you think you could teach me a guitar? Because I would love to learn how to play this song so I could fill a room just like this with a lot of love. You know what I mean?
Currently not taking new students.
I don't know how I'm supposed to feel about that, but we'll just roll with it. Mr. Hanson, what did you think?
I think Mr. Notice hit it right on the head there. You filled this room with a bunch of people that were very excited to be a part of that, right? They were dancing. I think I heard some singing along. Make sure we're not doing that. But I think, you know, especially after a little snafu to start, being able to bounce back, you know, I think is a sign of a very, very talented performer. And the whole concept of playing an instrument with two hands and singing on top of that is unimaginably commendable, in my opinion. And it sounded great, and I loved it, so thank you so much.
I see what you're doing, Mr. Hanson. You're trying to get lessons, so I can't. I totally understand it. Oh, okay, that makes sense. Mrs. Scarlett.
I agree with Mr. Hanson. I'm always impressed with people that can coordinate playing an instrument and singing at the same time and doing it all in a very calm and easy manner. You picked a song that was so good for your voice range. It was a great song. People love that song. People love Ed Sheeran. Your diction was great. I understood all the words, which is hard sometimes. And you were very impressive. Great job. Grace under pressure. Good job.
Mr. Stilettano.
So I actually love the fact that you had that little tech issue at the beginning, because that was perfect. It helped you loosen up, actually, and once you restarted, you were in the zone. It was really great. I think it helped relax you a little bit, so that kind of worked to your advantage. Again, I would also like to say it is not easy to get up, play an instrument, and sing, doing both things at the same time. It's really, really challenging. Great job. I love the fact that you added variety in the accompaniment. It's really important when you're a solo instrument, a solo voice, that you offer some variety in the rhythms that you're playing, which you did really nicely. Beautiful singing, again, really great song choice. I would just dive into the singing even more. Beginning and the end were great. In the middle, it's just kind of like you were singing, but it wasn't really singing, right? And then the last part that I would think about is, as you're doing, particularly the finger-picking style in the beginning, is make sure that the bass note is always on time. Sometimes it was a little bit out of tempo, and we really lock into the bass as audiences. So, but really, really outstanding job. Great job.
One more time for Mrs. Debbie Gross. Jeez, I got nervous. Now to introduce our next act at Gibbons Got Talent. Miss, she's an artist. You guys all love her, because I hear about you guys going to her room all the time. Mrs. Begoyne.
I next performer has created a unique type of act I have never seen done on the Gibbon stage before. She has been drawing for as long as she can remember, but only recently started working in digital drawing and painting. I cannot wait to see this amazingly talented artist in action. Give it up for the Purple Team's Emily X.
So just a bit of basic information on the app I used and what things I did to make this. Well, I used that Procreate on my iPad, and I used an Apple Pencil as a stylus, so yeah. So I made the sketch first, and then I did the line art, and then I colored. So you're gonna see that very soon, yeah. This character I am drawing is one of my own. You're not gonna see this like anywhere else if you search it up, because I didn't post this anywhere. And yeah, this character is called Sensei Sneezy, which one of my friends in this room might know. And he is an old man. He's supposed to be slightly wise and very silly. And I'm just about finished with coloring over here. I just have to add some of the shading, which I used a multiply layer for. I went over the multiply layer with a red color just to match the color scheme. And I did put some add and overlay layers so to give it some shine as the lighting. And that is Sensei Sneezy.
Wow, wow. So, Emma, could we just step right over here? So, what you're saying is you just created this all by yourself, no one helped you?
Yeah.
Oh, so this is an original creation, no one has this, this is not even anywhere on the internet.
Yeah, this is all my own.
So, do you plan on sharing it with the world, or are you going to keep this secret hidden forever for Sensei, how do you say it again?
Sensei Sneezy.
Sensei Sneezy. Well, my next question is, why is he called Sensei Sneezy?
He's kind of named after one of my friend's, like, nicknames.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
It's a bit of a long story, so I'm not going to tell it.
Do we have time? We don't have time. Okay, because we don't have time. Mr. Hansen, what do you think of this lovely drawing?
Wow. I don't know what to say. It's very cool. I don't know most of the words you said other than red. I heard like some layers and you put some red in there. And I'm very impressed, like both by your ability to like create this, but also to use that technology. And I think maybe a conversation Mr. Notice is gonna dive into. I don't know where somebody learns this, if this was just a hobby. If so, that's a very cool thing for somebody to teach themselves. Thank you for sharing with us.
Don't worry, I'm getting a lesson. Don't worry, I've already chosen. I'm getting a lesson. Mr. Silisano.
Like Ms. Burgoyne said, we've not seen something like this here at Gibbons Got Talent, and I want to say thank you for bringing this. This was beautiful. Not only was the drawing really outstanding, your coloring, I love the shading, all the work that you did there, but I love the way that you presented it to us, shared with us your process, explained the steps that you took to create this really cool work of art. This was really awesome. Great job, beautiful work, thank you.
It's an original, Mr. Sano, it's original. Mrs. Scarlett.
I agree, I'm so impressed with this. Your artistic talent along with your technological talent, is amazing, and I love how it's an original work, and you explained everything to us so well, and the character is just so cool, and I love the name. I love it's like a little cool, it's a little silly, it's a little, you know, combo there, and I don't know, I think it's amazing. Great job.
One more time for Emily G.
You guys have been an incredible audience so far. Please give yourselves one more round of applause for being an incredible audience. Introducing our next act in Gibbons Got Talent. She is also a math teacher. She teaches on the red team. She's not a math teacher, I'm sorry. She's an English teacher. Sorry, I'm only good at math, I'm sorry. That's it. She teaches on the red team. She teaches seventh grade. Mrs. Nottingham.
I am super excited to introduce this next act. These two girls have been friends since second grade, and now they're going to be joining us on stage and singing. So please welcome this beautiful singing duet, Abby Chaber and Emily Coffin. I
I don't know about you guys, but they made it real easy on me for this. They really did. Wow. How long have you guys been like singing together as like friends?
Well, we kind of just started like now because of the talent show. Mm-hmm. But we haven't like, we've known each other for a while, but we haven't like been singing together.
Okay, what's a while?
Second grade.
Second grade, it's really good. And you guys have been singing for how long individually? How long?
Oh, I've been singing for as long as I can remember.
Long as you can remember?
3-4 years.
3-4 years? One more time for these lovely ladies. I'm gonna go to Mr. Stilettano first. Mr. Stilettano. Oh, was it easy on you?
It was. That was lovely, very lovely. I just enjoyed sitting back and listening. Of course, not only do you sound great, but you look great with the matching outfits. Love that as well. And what I really enjoyed is as the song went on, you both just relaxed and it got more comfortable and confident, and the sound just grew and bloomed as the song went on. It was beautiful. The only thing I'd say is the two of you work really well together, so as hopefully you continue to work on stuff like this, embrace the duet part more. Rather than just singing everything together, maybe get a little harmonies or switching lines, things like that. But it was fabulous. I really enjoyed it. Thank you.
Very much so. Very much so. This is Scarlett.
That singing a duet like that together in sync for the whole song is super difficult, but you did make it look, and pun intended, easy. But I thought it was a great song choice. It was beautiful. You guys just were coordinating everything. Just your voices, your outfits, everything. It was sweet, and it was beautiful. I loved it.
I think we all love it, Mrs. Scott. I think we all do. Mr. Hanson.
Great song choice, in my opinion. I think that's Adele's best single. I love the outfits, like everybody agreed. Converse Gary represent, right? There's a lot of people out there, right? I love seeing your faces when you came out, and you're like, oh man, this is a full house, right? And then you settled in, and you guys owned it, and you rocked it. And I agree, Mr. Stilettano said it, you know, lean into your duet a little bit, you know, lean on each other a little bit, and kind of enjoy that time together up here. But that was very, very fun. Great job. Thank you.
One more time for Emily and Abby. I'm not gonna lie, these acts are making it look really easy up here. I would have to agree, judges. I would have to agree. Our next introducer for this performance, she is on the maroon team. I love her very much so. Mrs. Borden.
You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. How many times do I have to tell you? Even when you cry in your beautiful tune, the world is beating you down. I'm around through every move. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning, 'cause I give you all of me, and you give me all.
Mr. President, I don't know if you realize this. You've literally rocked the house. I hope you realize that. Just a reminder for you lovely audience people, please keep your phones inside your pockets at all times while we're doing the show. I do agree the light bar was a great thing, but please keep it inside your pockets. Jerry, everyone wants to know, since you are the president of this lovely class of 2026. Sorry, it's 2026. I can't count, I'm sorry. Jerry, how long have you been singing for?
Well, I started singing like when I was about 7, and then I stopped, and I kicked it up again like a year ago, so.
So it sounds like you missed it just a little bit.
I guess, yeah, you could say that.
Well, we're glad, I think everyone is glad that you picked this back up. Let's check in with the judges. Mrs. Scarlett.
Jerry, another great song choice. It was like, you were so smooth and focused and you had this connection with the audience. I love the smiles when your classmates really getting into it even more. And as you built into it, you got more comfortable. I love that. And you had your own little style at the end. You had some little trills and stuff in there at the end. And it was terrific. I thought you did a great job. Nicely done.
Mr. Sultano.
Jerry, I love me some John Legend, so I love that. Great choice. Really confident up on stage. I really enjoyed that. You have great support and energy through your sound, which is really, really great. Try it as you continue to work on your singing. Keep focus on your vowels and the space inside your mouth. And I can tell your hands wanted to do something. They were like starting to move. Let it happen, man. Let it happen, because it was the music moving you. And as soon as you let the music move you, you get to move them even more with the music. So go for it next time. Great job.
He definitely had fun to it, that is for sure. Mr. Hanson.
Excellent song choice, you know, great connection with the crowd. Your eyes, I don't know, were you like so, like Mr. Sotano said, like into it? I don't know if you saw the crowd, did you see all that happening? You were just in the zone, I love it. I can feel the passion in your voice, right, your love for singing, and also the way that you spoke those words, you know, you sang those words, you could really feel that you were making a connection with them. So great job, thank you for sharing.
One more time for Jerry! Introducing our next act. She is a brand new teacher this year. She's on the yellow team, Mrs. Mace.
Hi, I don't know why I'm nervous. I'm just introducing the act, but it gives me great pleasure to introduce a very talented member of the yellow team. She is not only an artist and a writer, but a talented musician. So here is Arushi Vora.
Thank you.
Wow. Now, Miss Vora, can you tell me, how long have you been playing piano for?
Since I was six.
Since you were six. Did you write that song yourself?
Yeah, I wrote it.
And just for the audience, since you wrote it yourself, what do you call that song?
I don't know yet. I haven't figured out a name.
Do we hope to have a name by the end of today or sometime soon?
I can try to figure something out.
Well, let's figure out what the judges thought. Mr. Stoltano.
Oh, Rushi, that was fabulous. I really, really, really enjoyed that. There's so many good things I can say. I'll try to limit it, because it was just great. I really liked, first of all, you had great form that allowed us to follow the song, great dynamic contrast, good variety of registers that you used. I really liked the sections where you had the variation on the melody with the 16th notes. Really, really great. If I had any critique for what you were doing, just two things is sometimes you had like a longer note followed by some space, especially like at the ending in the one or two spots in the middle. Hold on to that note, because the audience, you had the audience right here. You heard their reaction when they found out it was original, right? They were right here. Hang on to those moments with those long notes. Your audience will stay with you. And also, as you continue to work on your composition, beautiful lyrical writing in the right hand, try to remember when you have the melody in the right hand and making sure that the right hand is a little bit more prominent in the texture than the accompaniment in the left hand. Beautiful job, though. Beautiful.
Mr. Hanson.
Arushi, I gotta be honest, I was a little nervous at first because my preferred type of piano to listen to is when there's just hands flying everywhere and things are going crazy. But within the first measure, the first line there, you really pulled me in as we sort of, you know, sank down that line to the lower notes, and we kept hearing that motif over and over again, and it really kept me engaged the whole time. And then I spent from there most of the time staring at this paper that says original song by Arushi in just complete disbelief. I'm so impressed that you not only performed it as well as you did, but also that you wrote that. Congratulations to you. That's awesome.
Definitely agree. Mrs. Scarlett.
I also have to say I'm so impressed at the fact that you wrote this piece. It was beautiful, it was soothing. I love listening to it. I agree with both of my fellow judges. I loved how you had both registered. You did the upper register, the lower register. You had great finger work, great pedal work. I was watching all the action from over here, and I was just super impressed with all the coordination, and just you seemed to do it with such ease. I'm sure it wasn't easy, but you made it look so easy, and it was just so beautiful. Excellent job.
One more time for Arushi Vora! Just one moment as we clear the stage. Our next person introducing this next performer. She is loved by everyone in the whole school. Mrs. Cowgill!
Our next performer is from the Yellow Team. She comes with a lot of energy and a big smile, and she's a positive spirit in all of her classes. She's performing I Know It's Today from Shrek the Musical. Give it up for Danny Beaver.
That's just
set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by, a torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she were dead. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight. My white knight and his steed will look just like evil queen, filler, been there, read that seven shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with the start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear, and his armor will be blinding, as shining as his perfect teeth and manly heart.
Today, your day, for sure, Ms. Danica. Definitely your day. Now, we all want to know the curious question. Who helped you get dressed this morning? Because it is fabulous.
Abby
helped you out. Wow. Well, thank you, Abby. Thank you. Let's find out what the judges think of your performance. Ms. Scarlett.
So that is actually a very difficult song to tackle because it's written for three people, not one person, and you did a great job switching like the cadence and switching like the feeling and the emotion you're giving it. You have a strong voice, great tone, very musical theater-esque, and you just had great expressions. And you look like a princess. I love your outfit. Adorable.
Thank you.
Great job.
She's definitely shy. Mr. Sultano.
I would also like to say really nice singing. I enjoyed that. You had such a great understanding of the lyrics, of the story, and of the comedy of the text. What I'd like you to do, though, is be a performer, right? Be the storyteller. Think about really looking down and connecting with your audiences. Think about how you might be able to stage that a little bit using the stage and sides to your advantage, because the sound was really, really great. I can tell you knew what it meant. I just want you to storytell even more. Great work, though.
Mr. Hanson.
Very fun. As a Shrek stan, I didn't even know that song existed. I've never seen the musical. But I think you did a great job. I commented to the other judges that I think you have an awesome theater voice. You know, you're able to tell that story. That's not something that everybody who sings theater can do, right? They can't convey the story through their words, right? Whether they're mumbling or whether they, you know, can't convey it. But you did a really, really nice job with that.
One more time for Danica Beaver! Wow, there's a lot of great acts here. We still got more, people. We still have more. Introducing our next performer. She is on the blue team. She does teach English. Mrs. Ryan.
Mr. Hansen, I'm a little nervous about my job. Motif and measure? Wow, big words for a science guy. The next act that I'm introducing is from the blue team. This person is unbelievably talented, has won Writers Hall of Fame. Her art is on the cover of your yearbook. Her art is on the cover of the Writers Hall of Fame. I can't wait to see her talent on the dance floor. Introducing the magnificent Mahika.
Yours are way better. You're gonna have to teach me some of those. I'm not gonna lie. Mr. Hansen, what did you think?
Mahika, if I would have known you were holding on to that talent, we could have gotten a lot less done in science classes. Wow, that was so awesome. My only critique is I think you really, really, really would have benefited from adding a point to Mr. Notice and asking Mr. Massarelli to run the music back and bring Mr. Notice up on stage for a dance off. But other than that,
I think we would all love to see a dance off. I agree. Mr. Stilettano.
So even though I teach singing, I love the dancing acts. I just love it when people are confident in their bodies and their skill to be able to portray music through movement. It was so creative, it was so fun, it was very confident. I saw great shape in your body on all the different hit points and different moves that you were making. It was really, really impressive. Nice work.
Easy.
Mrs. Scarlett.
I love the mix of songs that you picked to do it, and I thought that your moves were, they were awesome. I can't even think about moving my body like that. I don't even know. But you just had so many terrific moves, and you were so in sync, and you never lost focus, even when people were clapping, like, and you were like, I'm on it. I am on it. You were just amazing. I don't even know how you did it. It was so terrific. Great job.
One more time for Mahika! Introducing our next act. He is one of our band teachers here at the school. Mr. Dufresne.
What's happening, Gibbons? Our next performer has been playing saxophone for the past 4 years, but he's not playing that for you today, no, no. He is playing the cello, and he'll be performing Bach's Suite Number 1. You might recognize this from Yo-Yo Ma, not to be confused with Yo Mama. Presenting Aiden Lawyer!
Let's find out what the judges think. Mr. Silitano.
All right, Aiden, first of all, great song, right? Everybody really recognizes, loves that piece of music. Really, really nice job. A couple of things to think about as you're continuing to work on the cello is, I believe on the first page in the A section, that first note has a little bit of a tenuto or accent or a lengthening of the first note, and I could go for a little bit more weight in the bow on that part there and a little bit more speed, particularly when you're playing on your lowest string, I'm losing some of that playing there. The right wrist, still a little bit tense, I know that's something you're working on, so that you can really get some nice flow with the bow. And remember, when you're playing this style of music, there should be a little bit more separation, particularly when you get to that exciting piece, the ending part, a little bit more separation in the phrasing to get the style, but really, really beautifully done on a really challenging piece of music. Awesome. Box music is one of a kind, Mr. Tom. This is Scarlett.
I thought you had such amazing control of the bow. I was watching the whole time and the fingering. It was amazing the way that you just were able to coordinate it like flawlessly. The dynamics were great. I love that you used a recognized piece that everyone likes and is familiar with. I'm always impressed with the string work. I think it's amazing how you can get such beautiful sounds on an instrument with just four strings and a bow and your fingers. I don't know. It's really great. It's beautiful. Great job.
Mr. Hanson.
Yeah, I agree with Mr. Stilettano. A little bit heavier on the bow because I really like when I'm watching somebody play a bowed instrument when I see strings breaking. So I would really like to see that addition. But really, really fun choice, right? I think you did a great job choosing that piece of music because even for those of us that might not be into classical music, it's a recognizable piece, which really allows these folks to engage with you. So good job with that. And I have heard that Yo-Yo Ma loves playing Mechanic Hall in Worcester. So when you make it there, I will certainly be in that audience. All right, great job.
Thank you. One more time for Aiden Moyer.
Oh, this next lovely teacher. He's always talking about acts of service. Definitely, definitely in his history class. Mr. Knorr!
What's going on, Gibbons? Last day of school! Yes! Let's get out of here! Okay. I have the honor and the privilege to be introducing the Blue Team's finest. A duet, I'd say the mightiest of mighty. Let's put our hands together for Arnie and Emma!
Running down to the river. song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause I'm gonna sing the word from. I just wanna know if you're gonna stay. I just gotta know. I can't have it any other way. I swear she's destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady running down the red tide, taken away to the dark side. I wanna be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you sing the word. Oh, lady running down to the riptide, taken away to the dark side. I'm feel that amen. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you sing the words wrong. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I'm gonna be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Yeah. I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong.
Listen, I'm excited that you're finally wearing the cowboy hat that you've been talking about for like 3 weeks. I'm super ecstatic.
I've been doing it for the past like 3 weeks, and you just don't notice it.
Well, that's just me. I thought we were friends.
You sure?
I'm just gonna talk to Emma from now on. Emma, how long have you guys been singing for?
Together?
Yes, together.
Like a month. 3 weeks.
Three weeks. I'd watch out for this one. I'd be careful. Just kidding. Also, so why'd you guys choose this song?
I didn't choose it, she forced me.
Now I understand. I understand. Judges, be careful of this one. Mr. Hansen, what'd you think?
Love the outfits, love the song choice. I too am afraid of those first three items. I love your group dynamic. I love how confident you were from the start and the way you interacted with each other. Great act, very fun to watch. Thank you.
Definitely agree. This is Scarlett.
I also agree, it was really, really fun. I love how you told the story of it. You acted it out, you had some moves, you had great facial expressions, you had some drama there. I loved it, I thought it was great. You did a terrific job, girls. Thank you, guys. I love the song too.
Mr. Stilettano.
Yeah, I mean, that was so polished. It was impressive. From the moment you walked on the stage to even your bantering with this guy right here. I mean, really, really impressive what you two just did on the stage. The group, your duo, nice work.
I would agree.
Arnie and Emma!
This next lovely teacher, he is on the purple team. He is one of the finest Americans that I know. Presenting Mr. Poland!
Hello, Gibbons. Before I introduce the next performer, I just wanted to say, I don't see where Mr. Kanoi, oh, he's way back there. Mr. Kanoi, that was great energy you brought up here introducing that act. If you showed half of that during the year, your team wouldn't have lost to my team in the Penny War or the Clothing Drive. Anywho, the next performer hails from the purple team. She is spunky. She is talkative. She is always positive. You've probably seen this throughout her day at Gibbons in the hallway. She spends most of her time there. Without further ado, I have the honor of introducing my second favorite Urbina, Lee.
How long is that?
3.
Since you were 3. Okay. All right. Had me nervous when you started counting your fingers there. We're both not good at math, so I understand. Mr. Hansen, please tell me what you thought of those lovely dandelions.
Having never heard that song for 98% of it, I could have easily been convinced that that was a studio version. You should be incredibly, tremendously proud. You look so nervous. You did such a great job. You killed it. No, that was very fun. You did a great job. You hit all those notes. It sounded what, in my head, I imagine exactly every single line was supposed to sound like musically. Great job.
Mr. Silitano. Great, great, great job. First of all, great song choice. That worked really well for your voice and for your face. You were able to really portray the song beautifully. What I would say, just a couple of things. First of all, remember to keep connected to the lower half to energize and support the sound. And try to focus the feet. I know that's a nerves thing, but if you can keep yourself a little more planted on the stage, it allows the audience to focus in more on you rather than the moving. And I think you can explore, especially when you're getting into music like that, levels with your body. Like, you got those really big notes you're hanging on to for a long time. Don't be afraid to dive down into your legs. You know, use a different part, use an arm. Do something to show us a little bit more when you get to those moments. But beautiful song choice.
This is Scarlett.
You have a beautiful, strong voice, and that was a great song choice for you. I love that song, and you did it justice. It was beautiful. You were feeling the music, you connected with the audience. I saw you looking around, trying to connect to each part of the audience, which I thought was great. And you just did a terrific job. You should be very proud.
One more time for you! Introducing our next act. She hails from the green team. She's a math teacher. Mrs. Sullivan!
Okay, we're almost done here. Our next act comes to you from the green team. She will be performing one of the oldest classical dances in India. Are you ready? I practiced. Bharatanatyam. Please welcome Shravya Gurujala.
Tell me, well, that was a lot of stomping going on and this and that. You gotta explain to me
What is that called?
Dance.
Well, yes, dance. What kind of dance?
It's Bharatanatyam, and like most of the dances in India, includes a lot of stomping.
Okay. That's a new one on me. It's magnificent, and you did it flawlessly. Let's go to our judges. Mrs. Tolkana.
Shravya, that was really, really great. I loved the confidence. I loved the posture. Your back had great form and shape to it, and your feet work really. I'm glad you were able to verbalize that to everybody, because I don't know if they saw the feet work, but it was really, really outstanding work. Very rhythmic and right on point. Awesome job, great.
Mr. Hansen.
That was very cool. I'm glad Mr. Notice gave us a little insight to like the cultural background of that dance and those type of dances. I don't know if people in the audience can see, but even like down to the way that your hands are moving and the shapes that you're making, clearly that required a lot of practice, a lot of focus, a lot of dedication, and we recognize that. So great job, thank you.
Mrs. Star.
I agree, you had great footwork and you had very intricate hand movements and the coordination of all of it together along with you had a great facial expression, you had confidence. It was lovely, it was beautiful, and your outfit's beautiful too. I love it. So you did a sure good job.
One more time for Shravya! Now for our next teacher, who is introducing our next act. She is on the maroon team. She teaches English. Mrs. Osmani!
All right guys, it's almost over. But before it's over, it's time to introduce a new act. So this student from the maroon team is not only a super talented musician, he's also a crazy fast typist. Fun fact, he once challenged me to a typing race on NitroType and beat me not once, but three different times. So, here to perform the third movement of Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, please welcome Dayon Sung.
Thank you. One quick question. How long have you been playing piano?
Since first grade, so 7 years.
7 years. Wow. Wow. You know, 7 years, you're able to do that. Wow. Let's start with Mr. Stilettano.
You get it. Yeah, man. That was great. So many good things. I can't even say all of it. But really great variety in your phrasing, your dynamic shifts. I really was impressed with hearing the melody over the accompaniment, both when it was in the right or the left hand as it switches throughout. Really, really great. As you continue to work on your fabulous, fabulous piano playing, just a couple brief moments of slight hesitation I heard in the recording, but in your playing, but really, really outstanding. That was phenomenal.
Mrs. Scarlett.
So beautifully played. If you had great attention to the dynamics, you had amazing finger work and pedal work. I was so impressed. It was amazing. It was flawless, and you made it look so simple. Again, I don't know how you do it. So great.
Mr. Hansen.
Yeah, those ivories have been tickled now, my friend. Great job. If there's one thing that I've learned from hanging out with Mr. Stilettano is that sometimes you're supposed to hear the melody part over the other part, and it was very obvious to me that that was happening. So in my opinion, you are a very good piano player. That was very awesome. Thank you.
We are nearing the end of our program, and we want to bring up our final teacher who's introducing our final act. She's from the Maroon team, science teacher, Mrs. Fillmore!
All right, Gibbons, I cannot think of a better way to close out the show, the day, the year, with a Maroon team student from my period 5 science class. She's a lovely lady, she's a great track athlete, and I hope she blows us away with her performance of All I Want by period 5 science, probably most requested person, artist, Olivia Rodrigo.
The door held my hand in the dark.
Engage with the audience. You were a great performer. You did a terrific job.
Mr. Hanson.
That was a phenomenal performance. Great stage work and confidence, and it was goosebump inducing, and it was, I think, exactly the way that Olivia would want that song performed and telling that story. Yeah, awesome job.
Final words, Mr. Stolitano.
That was beautiful, absolutely beautiful. First of all, beautiful. Second of all, if you don't join chorus next year, both you and your mom are getting beat up, all right? yes, Mrs. Cody, we need
to support us as well.
That was what we've been talking about. You owned the song, you owned the stage, you performed, you connected to your audiences. That was outstanding. Great job. Great.
So what we would love to do, we would love to bring all the acts on stage so they get their final applause. So every act come right on stage, right up here. For all the actors that performed today, you guys deserve a huge round of applause. Everyone, get up on your feet! Thank you enough. It was absolutely amazing. And we finally have the winner.
Jerry.
Okay. Here we go. Great song, by the way. And third, Miss Julia Cody. In second, Dae Young Sam. Just like, along with all the other acts that performed, she absolutely crushed it. Arushi Vora. Well done, thank you to the judges.